to do research. This is all my team. I go ahead directly to the introduction. I don't want to extend too much because sorry for the time. The piloting is a project, is pilot for robotic inspection and maintenance grounded on advanced intelligent platform and prototype applications. And the use case has been viaduct tunnels and refineries. These are the people who has been participating, the teams on piloting. Has been brave in and is ending just right now. And then I will speak in on the implementation of different artificial intelligence models to detect, classify, and segment defect on viaducts. All the images were taken from UAVs, and concretely the UAV of CATEC. Then in the viaduct case, a three-step system for detection, classification, and segmentation with data augmentation using to improve the whole system, okay? And we develop or use the GANs for due to limit data set available, we use the cyclic GAN, okay, to develop and generate new image, okay? Then, as introduction for FedSP, different model was testing, let me explain about the one of the more common and well-known is the YOLO. In concrete, we use the YOLO before. We use then the sweet transformer, a very good result. Then for cementation, we use the vice net. And for the generation, I told you, we use the cycle glass. As introduction for detection and classification, is the YOLO is the first approach to test the viability of the viaduct defect detector. As you already know, this YOLO is a CNN-based model designed for fast and accurate object detection and classification. As you see here, we use the COCO dataset. Okay, as you well know, it's a very huge dataset with different objects for detection and to test different algorithms. Here you can see the behavior. You see how we used it before, how the world, okay, accuracy has. Is a version tested for first support, good metric compared with other state-of-the-art models, and over 14% of average precision at the speed of 90 flips per second. And the key factor is the state forward implementation that has. As is well known, the generic structure of this model is use a backbone retaining on image net, then has a net which inserts and layers between backbone and head with the aim of collecting feature maps from different states. You can see here. Then the head is used to predict the classes and bonding boxes of the object. And the head, okay, includes a dense prediction part and is easy to part, can have a two-state object detector, and that technology include a spar detection part. In the case of YOLO before algorithm for backbone is formed by the CPA darknet. 56 is a neural network that enhances the learning capability of the CNN. The net is composed by two models that increase the reductive field and improve the parameter aggregation, that they use the spatial pyramid pooling model and use the path aggregation network models. And lastly, the head is used with the previous YOLO model, the V3. Already is the YOLO before already. Then to let you know, we have very few data available, but we test with the Colibri dataset. That this is Colibri is a dataset obtained from another previous European project called Aerobi for bridge defect detection by contact inspection. Then we use the data set collected, ¿vale? Of various viaduct under defect and several defects such as crack, spallation, corrosion, exposed bar and efflorescence. The data was divided in three groups for training, validation, and test. And as first approach, in order to test the availability of the method, we just trained the algorithm with only one class named defect. Okay. And these were the results of training. In general, you say how is the defect detection and how is the degree of accuracy. Here you can see this is with the YOLO. And fast evolution of YOLO network. There is another alternative version. We use the YOLO V4 large, okay, that you can see here. outperform state-of-the-art models. Now, as I told you already, is YOLO before. This tried to optimize the image size, the number of layers, and the number of channels when scaling using the GPS net backbone. Reducing the number of parameter computation, that can also improve the accuracy and reduce inference time. But we have to implement hardware limitation, and we don't follow this objective due to that. Then we solve this problem, you will see later on, with cloud computing. Okay. But before using that, we use the three transformers. Okay. That is at this moment, the transformer is more used than generally the neural network, the common neural network, okay? Because the key idea is dividing the image into elements called patch, and gradually this major neighborhood patcher in deeper transformer layer. The computational complexity is achieved by computing cell attention locally without no overlapping windows. This is the red one. And the partition the image, as you see, and inside every patch, the window is fixed. As you see here is the 4x4, and is divided, and then thus the complexity becomes linear. The three transformers surpass many of the state of the art of CNN already. With the three, achieve not only a better average precision on detection, but also on segmentation. And, you can see here, was tested using class of its defect, the swing transformer, crack, spallation, corrosion, and it was trained using CODIB, a data set was gathered from the experiment. And you see here was the average of the bounding box and the mask. That is actually very, very good. Here you see how well we use the Alora bridge. The bridge actually that we use because was the available by then user were in this case very good bridge with very, very few defects. But you see here one corrode the corrosion stain with a high percentage. Here you see spallation, okay, different kind of spallation. And here you can see corrosion and spallation. And the Alora image and images from the Viaduct were used to training, but to the people don't argue that the robustness of the algorithm get lost. We, in order to do this, we use some metrics like intersection over union, okay? That is an element using to see the metric, where give you the relation between false positive and negative, and you can see here that the level is high, is very good result between 0.7 and 0.9, because this is one is perfect and this end that can be overfitting, and 0 is a very bad network. Here you see another application of the Rio Verde bridge image. All these bridges are on Spain. Here you see a crack, corrosion, and spallation. And here you see the same for spallation, efflorescence, corrosion, okay, different kind of defects. You see here spallation and efflorescence, and the detection and more. After detection and classification, we had to segment the defect, and for that we use the BizNet. Okay, why? Because we saw that, as I told you, the hardware is actually a problem, the limited hardware that we had. Then we decide to train in cloud training. There are too many cloud training. We decide to use Lambda because the cost previous, you pay for what you use. Okay. In many time of them, you pay for every month or things like that. And here you pay for what you use. And another, the other try of network where you see only with compromised results. Okay. That they were no good at all. Okay, and there were the ResNet, for example, and things like that. No, it's the first that we use it with the ResNet using Ground CD and Apache MexNet. But don't very good result. Then we used to go ahead with Lambda using this net with the five segmentation network. We're telling with two types of systems. Okay, and the average training time was 8 hours, and training consisted of 80,000 epochs with a batch of 8 units per CPU. And just to let you know, the BizNet is a model that aims to improve inference speed without losing precision. Other models that do this increase the speed by reducing the size of the image, but this leads to reduced precision due to the loss of spatial details. Other increase the speed by pruning the channel of the network, but it weakens for the spatial capacity, I'm sorry. And to solve the loss of spatial details, research implemented the U-shaped structure that you see here, but it started to gradually increase the spatial resolution, but it slow down the inference. And also not all the spatial information can be recovered. And the BizNet has two parts. One is the spatial part, okay, that maintain the spatial information, and the other is the content path that is designed to prevent the sync of the receptive field. In the spatial path, tries to keep the image original size and spatial information, and this is now by tracking three convolution layers to extract the 1/8 feature mask with enough spatial details. And then the content path would utilize lightweight models and global average pooling to provide a large receptive field. Inside the context packs, we can find an attention refinement model, ERM, that you can see here how it's made, which captures the global context and creates an attention vector to guide the feature learning. Finally, the feature of both para user or the feature fusion model, that is this, that you can see here and obtain the segmentation. Then we use five networks. We're training one for each kind of defect. Okay, crack, spallation, corrosion, fluorescence, and exposed bar. The segmentation algorithm has as input the output from the detection and classification network. And the approach uses was to cross the bounding box of the defect detected in the previous step to do the inference on them and obtain the mask of that defect. And at the end, all the masks are joined to create the image defect mask. The metrics obtaining approach are really good. The AOU is 90-80%, and we use another score that is the F1. The F1 score makes sure the relativity between precision and exhaustivity. This is the what are the false positive and the excuse me false negative, and between the positive, well, how many were detected, and you see we reach more than near the 90%. Then you see here some examples where you see how is the spallation, how you obtain, how you segment. You see another image where you see the crack, the spallation, and the corrosion. Then here you have more examples that you saw merely previously, and you see here how is done the segmentation. And just to finalize, I would like to speak about the defect generation, how we use cycle GAN. First, we use the cycle V2, the GAN, cycle GAN V2, that was no good results. Finally, we use it due to the cycle GAN, because we have no data set and not. You can generate images, translation, and do things like that, but finally, you can find overfitting. Then, with the kind of network, we artificially generate the image that we propose. Actually, this neural network called generative adversarial network consists of two main models. One is the generator that is trained to generate images as realistic as possible, and then it has the discriminator, is trained to detect the real image. And the objective of this network is that the generator creates images realistic enough to fool the discriminator. And actually, we could obtain most of the image or defects we would generate in concrete images. If you use another kind of approach, for example, image-to-image translation, is a technique that allows translating image from domain A, o sea, healthy in our case, into domain B, which is image with defect. Normally, training this kind of network requires the data to be paired. That means an image from domain A must have its version domain B. In this case, the cycle GAN does not need the data to be paired, only through that needs a big enough data set, excuse me, for each domain. You can see here a corrosion training over time, input epoch 200, 500, and 800, and you see how you going to stand in better soil. Let's see here how you see spallation generation. Okay, and here the crack. You see how input versus output. And maybe as conclusion, just let me do, this has been validated and quality assessment in real breaches like Rio Verde, Alora, and another ones, but these were the principal. And we use the detection fan classification, we use the suite transformer, and for segmentation, we use the device net with very good intersection over union with very good result, bigger than the 17%, and the same for the one score. Finally, the defect generation, we use generate defect almost as any concrete image. The defect detection and classification has shown that a large version of the swing transformer model can improve can improve a lot the results. Then training with a meeting dataset generated with one improve the performance. And the defect segmentation, training different network, one for each defect, generally improve the results. And using cloud actually has helped a lot, that's known. And as a conclusion, the AI, robotics, and artificial intelligence application inspection and maintaining is very promising and very operator and system difficult access areas and is well known. Piloting use the three use case, Viaduct, tunnel, refineries, and all were very success, more or less using the 10 kind of images, the 10 kind of neural network and tested. Then it's true that AI is a tool and is here, as everybody knows, to keep with us. And aerial robotics supported by defect, a new application of the sector, like RIMA is a project for inspection and maintaining individual access. It's actually a network that just finished, but now there is an extension of this. Then another project, I use aerial robotics for electrical distribution network and detect different element and using también artificial intelligence, and as you well known, it's IMAR, that is the project who is supporting this course. And yes, I wanted to let you know the some conclusion that the users that were with us with the experiments, what they realized. They realized that the duration of inspection could be reduced by up to 5 times. More than 60% of the viaduct are covered compared to the 25% of the details covered by traditional inspections. The human intervention is significantly reduced, which improves the subjectivity of the inspection and the human risk. The drone has the ability to glide across the board and the repetitivity of the operation and autonomous flight. And the ability to photograph a site that are not usually accessible with manual inspection is all the good condition infrastructure through digitalized photograph and inspection reports. And something that was good is that they realized that they can take images for intersports and come back again to that place and do it again. Include show the end user with the results, and the operator can say, okay, this is a defect, this is not, you lose this defect, go ahead and train again and obtain new results. And thank you for your attention, and this is all. I try to be fast too, sorry for the... my problem on connection.
No problems, no worries. Thank you as well. I think there are some questions in the chat, and if everyone wants to ask anything else.
The using one class for all type of defect, no, we saw that is better results, training one network for each defect. We use it at the first time to see how to behave the network in general. Is you are going to obtain good results or not. But finally, to obtain the truth, and because actually you don't have very true defects in the sense because you mark because they told you that this is a defect, the end user who is on top of them, okay, they are interested on that, but they may not. That depends when they show, you say, here is a defect, they go there, that we did already, we mark with the UAV, we just put a mark, and they go ahead and check again. And what they use sometimes is the UAV can do it too, for connection, just to measure the deep, okay, or the, for example, of the crack, that they are more interested on that, than maybe some of the defects can be only how you say, that the bridge is the problem that for no nice to see, but the structure is well. You know what I mean? Then it's better to analyze the defects to use different one class, not for all types, you know, one class for each type. For us, gave us better results. And I think happened the same for the other cases.